Hey guys, watch this video and I'll show you how to build these stairs. Okay guys, so today we're building a staircase down the side of a house. It's between two walls. What's challenging about this one is the retaining wall has a whole heap of piers in it, steps in and out, which just makes it hard to mark out. I'll try my best to explain everything clearly, but that's the challenge with these videos, is showing what I want to show. All right, let's get into it.
We need to build stairs coming all the way up.
It's never pretty what we're working at. The guy I'm building these for has already marked one side. What I'm going to show you this time is how I measure my rises. So rather than use a tape from side to side, I'll use this. Okay, now all I have to do, butt it onto the wall, sends a dot onto the other side, line it up with where I need, I press the button, and then it comes up in my phone. So do the next one. There it is there. Now I'm going to show you how I cut my rises. Usually I'll cut three sheets at a time. So when I cut three sheets at a time, okay, with a 30 degree angle, if you stagger your ply 10 mil, when you cut your 30 degree angle, the length of this will be the same as the length of the bottom one. I've already cut most of them, so I'm just going to show you on one. I've got to cut about three more pieces. So I'll measure my marks. I always cut an angle on my rises. I don't use this saw very often. I only use it when I'm cutting these risers and three sheets at a time. The angle on the bottom of the stair, so by having a point, you've only got like half a millimeter of ply that'll get seen. Now the other thing we do, you might notice my pencil line's there. Come on, focus. We want this concrete to be on a bit of an angle, so that, because these are external stairs, as there's water on it, it'll fall away. You don't want the water sitting and pooling at the front of the step. Okay, so we got to build our next three steps. I usually just build three or four at a time. I don't build the whole lot because if I've made a mistake and stuffed something up, at least I haven't gone too far. So we got, they're all 1485. Now we're going to take off 3 mil just so it fits easy. 1482. Got cleats on both sides, so we take off. So that's our ply size. And our timber size, we're going to take off 72 mil, 14, 10. Okay, three of each. Yeah, hit the cleat in a touch, angles it, makes it a lot easier to get in. When you shoot the nails, if you pull back on the gun and time it right, you can leave the head out a touch. I'll show you here. Perfect. If you just nail normally, nail is flush. But if I go, see? One of the great things about using ply on there to nail everything too is your measurements don't have to be as accurate. You can actually have a slight gap here and it still sort of fits like that one did. Whereas if you don't do that and you just put cleats straight to the wall and fix straight to the wall, you have to have your measurements so accurate. This is more forgiving. When you're nailing these cleats, you want a nice spread, and that stops it twisting. If you put all your nails grouped in one area, it's gonna twist. So when concrete hits this face, it'll twist. These stairs are complete. So they're only lightly braced. All these risers are 1450 wide, which with the timbers I'm using, and they're only 160 rise, they won't bow. It's right at the point where they just start to bow. So I've just braced the wide ones, but I haven't over braced it. They don't really need it. Stepped around piers. A little brace between just to keep them just for a bit of extra. Job done.
Okay guys, that's it on this one. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you got something from it. Subscribe and I'll see you on the next one.